This next story getting a lot of attention today because of its headline. A man in Virginia attacked his wife with a hatchet, and then he took his own life with a chainsaw. An absolutely tragic situation, but what gets lost in that sensational headline is this: domestic violence. WSA9's Michael Quander breaks down what happened and what the county is trying to do to stop a growing wave of domestic violence.
Give me a rescue in here now. Give me a rescue in here.
In a matter of seconds.
Okay, what's the duty officer know? I am definitely going to need CIP and crime scene.
Scanner traffic shows the moments Fairfax County police found out they were at a gruesome and deadly crime scene.
Can you advise on the patient's condition?
Critical.
Cleaning specialists left this home Thursday after officers say a man who lived here attacked his wife with a hatchet. A family member rescued that woman, and there was a fight in the front yard. Investigators say that man later killed himself in the garage using a chainsaw. House after house.
Hey, is anybody home?
Neighbors didn't want to talk about what went down on Springfield Hills Drive.
Appreciate it. Thank you.
Like everybody else, I was very shocked, yeah.
Friends leaving the family's home say the woman is out of the hospital.
How's she doing?
She's doing fine. You know, I think she's not over the shock yet.
You know, at the end of the day, this is a tough situation for not only this family, but for this entire community to deal with. It's a case that shines a light on a much bigger problem.
Does it get hard to deal with sometimes?
Absolutely, it's devastating.
Nicole Acosta with Fairfax County says domestic violence is a problem. Just last year, there were nearly 200 families looking for emergency shelter, and the county helped more than 1,000 victims. That's up 250 from last year.
I survived domestic violence.
Fairfax County is receiving fewer calls to its hotline, but data from last year shows more than 74,000 hotline calls across the state.
I think what we are seeing is we're seeing survivors who are reporting the domestic violence to law enforcement with increased risk for potential serious injury or homicide.
Just one of many things being done to hopefully prevent something like this from happening again. Reporting in Springfield, Michael Quander.
It's unbelievable.
WUSA 9.
Fairfax County also has a program where they train abusers on how to change their behavior. If you or anyone you know needs help, call the hotline, 703-360-7273. We'll have that number for you on WSA9.com.